Hello again. This is another look back to my time in hospital. This time it's day two, which will have been the 19th of November, Wednesday the 19th of November, 2008. I left off, I was in ICU, getting looked after by a nurse all night, and I carried on the next day. The nurses changed over into the day shift, and I had another really good nurse. She washed me, washed all the iodine off my body, she kept giving me morphine. The morning was really pretty much uneventful. She washed me, gave me morphine, but it was making me sick. But really, every now and again, I felt really sick, really nauseous. And she stopped the morphine eventually, but I felt like I was going to throw up, and I was holding like a bed plant in my mouth, and I just let out a massive burp. It was the biggest burp you've ever heard, and it just cleared the water off my the air out of my chest cavity or something, and I felt much better after that. She stopped the morphine because it was making me feel sick, and I started to feel a lot better, come round, and the pain wasn't that bad. I was sitting up and talking, but I certainly didn't want to get out of bed. I didn't really want to put my shorts on. I was just sat there in my gown. I was quite happy. A couple of more nurses came over a little bit later on, and they sort of did a procedure where they roll you onto your side and take the sheet out from underneath you, then roll you on the other side and fully take the sheet out, then put a new sheet on and roll you again and again and sort of change your bed like that so you don't have to move. And it was a little bit painful, but got a new bed after that. I met the surgeon, and I've no idea really what he said to me. I know he said that it was a success and things like that, but he spoke for just a couple of minutes. I can't remember exactly what about. Later on, we went over to. I was supposed to get a bed on the ward, but there wasn't any free beds anywhere on the ward. So I spent another night in ICU. So they wheeled me over to the other side of the room, put me in a bay there, and the night shift nurses came on, who were amazing. They were really good girls. They were younger girls. There was three of them, and one of them was looking after me, but the other two were all around as well. They were young girls. They were quite fit, quite lively, and they were just quite fun to chat to. At one point, a little bit later on, I think they thought everyone was sort of comatose and on morphine and that, and they were talking about a strip club that one of them went to and how she got a dance off a girl, and not really knowing what was going on, but how she enjoyed it, and realised I was there. I was like listening into all this, and then they laughed, and just chatted to them all night. It was surreal. I really enjoyed the second night in the ICU. I wasn't on the morphine, but I was on painkillers, quite strong painkillers, and quite a lot of them, and it was good to be taking them. I had a dry throat, but just spent most of the night not really being able to sleep, and just chatting to these three young sort of, two of them were student nurses, and the other one was just another young nurse. It was kind of alright. When morning came, things, I don't know, took a bit of a negative turn though. I still had my chest tubes in here. Three tubes sort of coming out of here, and they started to bleed a little bit, which is normal, but it means that you can't take them out apparently. Even though it was sort of a normal level of bleeding, only a very sort of slow amount, and the paediatric doctors didn't want to let me have it out. This sort of fed in the morning and gave me a little bit more pain, and started to increase and become more and more uncomfortable. Where I'd gained a little range of movement, I could sit up and shuffle a little bit. I sort of became harder again. Sort of took a step backwards in terms of range of movement. But I'll get onto that in the next post anyway.